right, it's Dexter. Oh yeah, Father's a... Oh wait, is this the? This is just like my favorite high impact action soap. Is that in this one?
Yeah, that's that one. Father,
what's he doing here? Or is it the other one?
Father, what's he doing here? But if
Father is in the lab, okay, yeah. The next time we see Dexter, he says this is just like my favorite high impact action soap.
Yeah.
And no kid is gonna understand what The Young and the Restless is.
Yeah, it's a soap opera.
The joke would just fly over many kids' heads. I only know it because my grandma would constantly watch it. So yeah. I've actually watched like a good bit of the show.
Yeah. I don't understand the consistency of the heroes becoming villains in this, or becoming creepypasta controlled counters. Like,
yay, we get to play as the best character.
Yeah, like, why is Shadow, underneath my control, but why isn't Flapjack underneath my control? Like, why?
I don't know. The villains choose specific characters to mind control.
Because I would like to think that the villains are fighting, the villain is controlling the heroes that try to fight back. Like, Nigel Uno, Buttercup, those characters would be fighting back, and that's why they became evil. But then you got Shadow, and why would he be evil? He's not fighting back. I'm stuck as Bubbles? Okay, fine. I guess I'm Bubbles.
Well, maybe it's like one character. Yeah, you're stuck as Bubbles because of the
minigame, yeah.
Yeah, the minigame that lasts like 8 minutes long.
They couldn't
really
have
annoying.
You play as Blossom for that minigame. They only... You can only be Bubbles.
Are you ready for him to say the exact same thing again? As in the cutscene? It's the city of Townsville. Home of the... Yeah. There you go.
It's Buttercup. She's back.
Okay, no time to talk about it right now, Buttercup. Mojo Jojo's on a rampage, and we need to save Townsville from being destroyed. Stay in a tight formation. This place is like a maze.
Okay.
Good voice acting.
So what's your favorite episode?
Stay in a tight formation, and by that I mean I'm gonna run ahead and you try and lag behind.
Freaking cool. So who's your favorite, what's your favorite episode of Powerpuff Girls?
Oh god, the Wi-Fi. That's my favorite episode, is oh god, the Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
Okay, alright.
Time for me to leave you, okay. Bye-bye.
I guess I'll wait for it to come back then. Okay, now the Wi-Fi is back. Yeah, it just froze for like 10 straight seconds there.
10 straight seconds.
Yeah, Wi-Fi is worse today than it was any other day, which is weird.
Yeah. I don't know why.
Anyway, favorite episode of the Powerpuff Girls. You know, the thing that stinks, I really love the show, but at the same time, I can't remember a lot of the episodes I've watched.
Why?
I don't know, it's weird. Like, it's weird, like, unless I'm super into the show, like, Steven Universe is a lot of episodes I remember, even though I watched it all in 1 week. But, like, if it's something that I've only seen a few episodes of every now and then...
Yeah.
So, like, the Powerpuff Girls, I've seen, like, probably half a season,
well, with
but
something
they're
like
all
SpongeBob,
spaced out.
With something like SpongeBob or Simpsons, you know, the reruns are still on TV, and they keep playing over and over again, so you can still watch them. While with Powerpuff Girls, you can't watch them unless you have HBO Max or like that, where you can actually watch them, you know?
Or, you know, DVD box sets.
Yeah, that too, but do you have a DVD box set of Powerpuff Girls?
I wish.
We should get
I think
one.
They... I think they're available on Amazon. I shouldn't have bought
them.
They
are. You should get one.
Go up. There you go.
Fun fact, I saw a DVD box set of My Life as a Teenage Robot at a pawn shop. Actually, not a pawn shop, but, one of those Goodwill stores for like $1, but I didn't buy it.
Sweet!
I didn't buy it.
I've been looking for a DVD box set. They have seasons 1 through 3 on Amazon. But it's like $30, and yeah. I don't know if I mean
they had all three seasons of.
I mean, just yet. I don't know if because I have Paramount Plus, so it's like I don't know if I want to buy it for that much just yet. No, get me back up there.
Yeah, go. But is like any bonus features on the DVD box set, like behind the scenes, behind the making of the show?
I wouldn't watch it.
Why?
I don't know. I'm not like that when it comes to I'm not like that when it comes to shows. I don't really watch, like, behind-the-scenes stuff.
I do.
Unless it's, like, The Neverhood. I really like watching the behind-the-scenes of The Neverhood, because that one's weird.
You should watch the behind-the-scenes or behind-the-making of, Special Planet's very cool.
Well, I mean, I have a DVD of it. It's probably on that.
Yeah, it is.
Anyway, I guess I sit back and relax.
Yeah, for like 8 minutes.
Well, unless you get hurt, 160% more, and then you you have to restart because 300% is the maximum.
Yeah. So
And also the freaking laser sounds are so loud.
Yeah. I can turn on the volume. Let me try.
I mean, no, I can't even hear it. So.
I know, but for the audience, yeah. There we go, much better.
Okay, go on, what were you gonna say?
What's your favorite joke from Pop, of course, if you can't remember an episode?
The only joke that I remember is the one that people constantly bring up, where, what? Where the Powerpuff Girls are talking about how they're made, and then another girl says, oh, it's okay, I'm a mistake too.
You like that joke a lot?
It's the one joke that I remember people talking about, and that's...
One joke no one talks about, but it's really dirty, and I don't get how it got aired on TV.
Okay.
You know Sailor Bellum?
Yeah.
She lives, her dress that she lives in the Powerpuff Girls universe in Townville, is 69 Yodel in the Valley Lane. Do you know what that means?
Well, you know what? You'll probably explain it to me. I know the 69, but I'm
Yeah, 69, but Yodel in the Valley is 69 again. It means the same exact thing as 69.
Oh, okay.
It means, you know, to lick a woman between the legs. So, they put that in a kid's show. I guess they knew, you know, people like Sailor Bam a lot, so.
Yeah, I'm guessing, I mean, I guess they knew people, one, wouldn't under, like, kids wouldn't understand
yeah,
it.
Yeah, kids wouldn't
get
it.
If it's a very small, like, side gag that's, you don't, like, isn't told, it's just seen, then yeah. They could probably get away with it.
Yeah, they would. Well, I know that your favorite
if you get hit 50% more times, you're gonna die!
No, I won't. I'm gonna live.
Ram!
I'm gonna live. I'm gonna live.
You're living on the edge.
Yeah, I am. But I know that your favorite character in Powerpuff Girls is Blossom, but who's your favorite villain?
I like the gorillas guy.
Why you like him?
Because he was in the famous gorillas music videos, and then
yeah,
the Powerpuff Girls.
I forgot
stole
his
him.
Name is, but he's from the you know the gang Green Gang.
I mean I don't know a lot of the villains from Powerpuff Girls.
I know he's from the gang Green Gang, but I can't remember his exact name. I know he has a name.
Like Zaz or something, or is that a character from freaking Sonic Lost World?
No, Zaz is from Batman.
Oh, well, Zaz is also a character from Sonic Lost World.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he's purple, and he's like Nostalgia Critic, basically.
Does he kill people and put stitches on his body to count each one?
No, but he
That's
screams
Batman's
a lot problem. And talks about killing people.
Oh, there you go. Same exact one, then. I gotta do this minigame, too? Fine.
I hate this minigame so much.
It's the same thing as a Flapjack minigame.
Well, the freaking buildings are blocking the way to his chest, so you just have to wait until he destroys the taller buildings.
Just
to
like
hit
that.
His chest.
Just like that. I'm not...
Yeah, I mean, I guess Mojo Jojo's the one that I just...
You like the most? Okay.
Yeah, I mean, Mojo Jojo's just the one that, like, comes to mind.
I mean, he's the main villain, so...
Oh!
Yeah.
You went through the building.
I did.
You know what? My favorite villain.
What'd I do?
Is
I just see him.
Monkey
Jeez.
Number. Monkey number 500 from the Powerpuff Girls movie.
Why?
Because it's monkey number 500.
What does he say? What's his quote?
That's the most recent Powerpuff Girls related like media I saw. I watched the movie last year, like early last year.
You didn't watch Dance Pants?
No. I really like the art style in Dance Pants.
Yeah. You didn't watch the tenth anniversary of Papa's Girls special that was on TV in like 2009?
No, I just watched the movie because I haven't watched the movie in like 5 years, so I decided to watch the movie.
Well, the 10-year anniversary of Papa's Girls special had like Mojo Jojo singing "Everybody Wants to Rule the World."
That does sound pretty good.
It sounds pretty good, and he does the prairie dog meme thing. Well, you know, spies that prairie dog thing, groundhog. You know that meme.
Use special.
What, you want me to use my special? Fine.
Yeah, use your special. There you go. Freaking get these guys out of here.
Anyways, I guess my favorite villain is Sedusa. I like Sedusa.
Of course it is.
Why?
That definitely seems like it's your favorite villain.
Why? How'd you know?
Feels good to be fighting together again. You call that fighting? I'm just getting warmed up to pound Mojo Jojo in the next week.
Hey, real nice job at not losing.